While police say they tried repeatedly to de-escalate the situation, family members exclusively talking to 11 News saying that the man simply should not be dead.
Y'all killed my cousin! Man, don't touch me!
Raw emotion.
He was a friend. He was a confidant.
Spilling beyond the police tape.
Explain to me why my cousin did. How he get shot in the back by the police? His back turned. How's he dead?
As investigators tell us, officers were forced to shoot and kill a man.
And these officers repeatedly went into their de-escalation techniques.
As he held a woman hostage, while other family members were told were hiding inside the home.
When you're dealing with someone who clearly will take someone's life, they have to react in the way that they're doing their other training.
Officers just after 10:30 Sunday morning responding to East Lafayette Avenue near North Durham Street to a family disturbance. Once inside the home, they say they found the man holding a female relative at knife point.
This suspect grabbed the victim apparently by her hair and motioned as if he was going to stab her with a large knife that he had in his hand.
That's when one, possibly two officers shot and killed the man, leaving his family, they tell us, filled with grief and disappointment.
I wish you was here to see his mother, man.
About the officers' use of deadly force.
They got tasers.
Okay, speak about that.
They got knife sticks.
Speak about that.
Why you had to shoot him? Why?
Some of the man's loved ones responding with actions to possibly help the city.
We're going to try to join this crisis team.
That's the next move for this family.
That's the next move for me.
To quell an issue they say is deep rooted in their community.
Mental illness is real across the globe.
We're joined in this crisis team.
It definitely affects our people even more, and we need help.
And police have not commented on the man's mental status. The woman was not heard, as police say they are reviewing body-worn cameras. Live downtown, I'm Trey Ward, WBAL-TV 11 News.